stuffy and in need of therapy. The prescription we wrote for ourselves was to laugh at ourselves. A friend who had photography as a hobby volunteered to bring his camera and lights to the school, and we proceeded to shoot a film a la Casablanca without a script and on weekends and evenings. The film had worldwide screenings because of the brilliant acting performances. Hope you enjoy it. This is Homer Smith, professor and chairman of the Department of Physiology, seated at his desk, reviewing data obtained on a study of a patient in Bellevue Hospital. He senses a breakthrough. He studies the situation through a window, returns to his desk, looks at the data, senses the idea that a conference is needed, and finds three of his collaborators wetting their throats at the bar next door to the school. One of us are called to the phone. And a meeting is set. Members of the collaboration arrive at the medical school. That's Helmut Ranges and William Goldring. We rise to the fifth floor, the office of the Department of Physiology. A windy, wintry day, but we stalwarts don't mind the weather. Smith greets the team, and we go into executive session. The question that we will attempt to investigate and find an answer to is the action of adrenaline on both the kidney hemodynamics as well as systemic hemodynamics. Opinion, and after some hours of discussion, we decide to test each other's ideas, and finally, we are asked to schedule them in such a way as they can be seen by other members. Debate continues. Each one of us goes to the board to defend our thesis. Systolic pressure increases, diastolic pressure increases. Complete systolic increases and diastolic does a dance. That seemed to meet with general agreement. And everybody congratulates the investigator. That's Joe Rangy's. That probably was the 18th attempt, but we only filmed the successful one. An infusion of inulin is started. And there's the blood sample going into the pocket. Calculated. Jim Shannon appears on the scene, looks over the data, and in his usual manner disagrees, shows his general disgust, and leaves. Then the cartographer, a second year medical student, draws the chart from which the Latin slides are to be made for the speech. The second year medical student's name was Barbara Parker. The paper is typed. The news is out. The results are earth-shaking. We needed a large auditorium for the presentation of the data. And we hired Madison Square Garden. And as you see, scientists from all over the world attended. Every seat in Madison Square Garden was taken. And the results are presented by Homer Smith to the audience. Some of the collaborators listening. Finally, the great conclusion is presented. He shows the chart that you saw being prepared. General agreement among the collaborators, and then the announcement. As you see, the audience is intrigued, waiting expectantly. That was Dugald Brown and Rudy Nauman. And there it is. And one member of the audience, Homer Smith Scotty, applauded.